All of the objects in the universe are in an extremely complex dance, constantly being pulled in a variety of directions by other massive objects. The entire motion of the cosmos, how planets revolve around stars, how stars move around galaxies, and how galaxies shift in space is explained by the pull of gravity. However, research claims that not only are we being pulled in a variety of directions, we're also being pushed on by a mysterious force. This is Unveiled, and today we're taking a closer look at the huge force that's pushing against our galaxy right now. Do you need the big questions answered? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one, and ring the bell for more thought-provoking content. To understand how this force is affecting our speed in the universe, we can think of the universal structure as groundwork. A planetary system, or solar system, comprises a star and objects, such as planets, that orbit around it. A galaxy consists of millions of stars, many with their own planetary systems, as well as gas, dust, and dark matter. Our solar system is located in the interstellar cloud known as the local fluff, which is part of the Orion arm of our galaxy, the Milky Way. And just as stars come together, bound by gravity, so too do galaxies. The Milky Way is part of a collection of galaxies known as the Local Group. The Milky Way, together with the Andromeda and Triangulum galaxies, as well as dozens of smaller dwarf galaxies, make up this group. In general, a group is formed of 50 or fewer galaxies, while for large masses of 50 or more, the term is clusters. Altogether, our local group runs for about 10 million light years in diameter. Our neighborhood of galaxies stretches far across space, but the scale of structures in the universe gets even bigger than that. Superclusters are wider formations of regular galactic groups and clusters, and the supercluster that our local group is part of is called the Virgo. What's incredible, though, is that there are an estimated 10 million or more superclusters in the observable universe, total, interconnected for the most part. However, there are also vast areas, sprawling cosmic voids that are mostly empty of anything, and they're crucial to what's apparently happening to us. All of the galaxies and groups and clusters and superclusters in the universe are being pulled in any number of directions, but overall, they gravitate towards the largest collection of mass. At the same time, however, the expansion of the universe has to be taken into account. Expansion is moving objects in space independently of gravity, and it's been doing so since the Big Bang. To separate out this vital factor, then, scientists refer to the speed of galaxies due to gravity as peculiar velocity. And so, back to the mysterious force that's pushing against the Milky Way. As it happens, our entire area of space is currently being pulled towards another massive concentration of galaxies called the Shapley Supercluster. The problem is, however, that the force of that pull isn't massive enough to account for how fast we're speeding towards it. Even with expansion taken into consideration, the numbers just don't add up. And this led scientists in 2017 to propose the existence of another force, our mysterious force, on the opposite side of the Milky Way, pushing it and us onwards. They call this force the Dipole Repeller. However, the Dipole Repeller is actually a particularly large cosmic void, a supervoid. How did we get to this conclusion? Using redshift and blueshift observations, the researchers made a map of the gravitational flow in our area of the universe, dubbed the Cosmic Flows Project. In doing so, Lead researcher Professor Yehuda Hoffman discovered the speeds exhibited by the local group didn't match up to what would be expected. And the only thing that could explain this contradiction was, again, the presence of another massive force pressing against us, propelling us forward. In fact, this object, or probable lack of objects, accounts for about 50% of our overall motion towards the Shapley supercluster. Hoffman explained it like this. In addition to being pulled towards the Shapley concentration, we're also being pushed away from the newly discovered Dipole Repeller. But the name Dipole Repeller might be a bit misleading. It essentially functions to repel us, but actually, it isn't exerting any force on us at all. We know that gravity is unique among the cosmic forces because it always attracts and never repels. Nevertheless, while it can't push us, it can appear to. If we picture our local group as a metal ball and the Shapley supercluster as a massive magnet, we'll naturally roll in that direction. However, for our area of space, we have that massive pull coming from one direction and a lack of any pull coming from the other direction, from the Dipole Repeller supervoid. As astrophysicist Ethan Siegel explains, gravity is never repulsive, but a less attractive force in one direction than all the others behaves indistinguishably from a repulsion. And that's what's happening here. The Dipole Repeller is a cosmic void that holds very little matter, although it still isn't completely empty. It's only empty relative to the abundance of stars, galaxies, and planets elsewhere in the universe, which is why the amount of gravity it exerts is basically an unnoticeable amount. It's like it's a cosmic ghost town, sitting about 500 million light years away from Earth and in the opposite direction to the Shapley supercluster. But even so, it's this which is to blame for our mysterious force. There's nothing much there, but it's still having a major impact. So far, we haven't actually observed the Dipole Repeller directly. The scientists who theorize its existence have inferred it's there from the speed of galaxies relative to the amount of matter pulling on us. Voids or dark spots of any size can't easily be seen through a telescope, and so are often measured based on indirect evidence. For further research, though, there's an aim to more closely look at the few galaxies that are contained within the Dipole Repeller. That's also a challenge, thanks to the cosmic dust cluttering the way between us and them. But if we could gain a better understanding of these places, we might also know more about why we move through space as we do. Mapping the gravitational flow in the overall universe is an important next step for humanity, and knowing in detail about structures like the Dipole Repeller could be crucial in the future. To grasp exactly how fast galaxies are moving and why. At the same time, astrophysicists regularly use gravitational pull to their benefit when launching spacecraft. Space travel isn't as simple as just pointing your vehicle in one direction and turning on the thrusters. It's much more efficient to sail the gravitational waves, and scientists currently use other planets' gravity to accelerate or change the direction of probes in just the solar system, a neat trick known as a gravity assist or slingshot. Many years from now, however, humanity might be planning an intergalactic voyage much further afield, at which point, gravity assists will be a whole new ballgame, and in order to take advantage of slingshotting, we'll have to have precise knowledge of the cosmic flow. For now, we more simply know the universe is filled with galactic groups, clusters, superclusters, and cosmic voids, and that all of it's under the spell of gravity, as well as another impetus, expansion. Gravity works in peculiar ways, though, so that even areas of space that apparently exert no gravity can appear to push us, as per the Dipole Repeller. And that's how scientists discovered a huge force that's pushing against our galaxy right now.
What do you think? Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments. Check out these other clips from Unveiled, and make sure you subscribe and ring the bell for our latest content.